Hey guys, today I'm going to show you how to use the slicer on how to make a 3D printed stamp. There it is, right there. Okay, Perry Family 2. Okay, now we can't print this directly. We can't print the STL straight from the 3D printer. We have to go through first what's called the slicer. And most 3D printers have their own slicer or have a slicer that they recommend. We're going to jump into Prusa slicer right now. I highly recommend all Prusa stuff. They're just awesome. So here we are. We're going to go over here to our desktop. And there is my STL too. I'm going to throw it over here. And there we are. So it's on the build plate here, but it's not oriented correctly. So next thing I need to do is select it, and then I want to pick which is the base. Is it going to print on this side? No, that would be kind of weird. Is it going to print on this side? No, then you'd have these huge cliffs of overhang here that wouldn't print well. There's an obvious side. This is the side we want to print on. And we can rotate it whichever way we want. You know, it doesn't really matter how it's rotated here. But that's what we would do. Then we just go over here, you make sure your settings are correct. We're not going to go through the settings on this video, but you say slice now, and it's going to generate what's called G code. Let's export this G code. And G code is what the computer reads, what the 3D printer reads to tell it what to do. So there is my G code. I press open, nothing happens there because it's just a bunch of digital commands for the 3D printer. So that, my friends, is how we make a 3D printed stamp. First, we go to Illustrator and we create an SVG file. Then we go into Fusion 360 or similar program and create an STL file. And then we take that STL file, put it in the slicer, slice and dice it, and it spits out a G-code file, which we then 3D print to make our stamps. And that's all there is to it, guys. I'm MJ Perry at Outpost Pottery. Thanks for watching and keep on learning.